we're looking at germanium at 5.9's purity producing about 8 tons next year, 8 metric tons, which is pretty large. I mean, that can satisfy most of our defense industry.
Hey, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Mark Jensen. He is the CEO of American Resources Corp. And Mark, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Steve, I'm doing great. Sitting here in our ReElement facility.
Oh, perfect. Because we're talking about that today, as a matter of fact. That's your subsidiary. And you put out a news release talking about the ability to now get ultra-high purity germanium. So let's start there. Tell everyone a little bit about this metal and what it's used for.
Yeah, absolutely. So germanium is a product that we got introduced to about 9 months ago that we got asked if we could refine it by some different defense contractors. It's used in optics, lenses, drones, missile defense systems, and became pretty crucial when China started banning these materials. So we developed a flow sheet for it, and now we're producing greater than 99.9% purity for it.
Yeah. And again, I come back to the point that you've talked about in the past, the fact that because of the technology that you have, you can pretty well try and use it for anything. And here's another example of that.
Yeah, absolutely. So our process is we get offered these opportunities, then we develop the process for it, and then we go source the feedstock. Extremely versatile technology, scalable, modular. We're looking at germanium at 5.9's purity, producing about 8 tons next year. 8 metric tons, which is pretty large. I mean, that can satisfy most of our defense industry. And that is the versatility of our technology, which makes it really unique currently today with our goal of making rare earths no longer rare and no longer critical.
Yeah. Mark, as far as the germanium is concerned, can you sort of talk about the process and getting to that point? Is there a lot of testing that has to be done in order to get it to that purity level and the importance of that?
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, when you're going to 5.9's purity, you need to use extremely pure water, extremely pure chemicals, so that your process doesn't contaminate it. So we've been really this, over the last 6 months, we've started focusing on these higher purity materials that were needed. So yttrium, gadolinium, germanium. And so it takes the time to develop the flow sheet for it, but the technology is high purity oriented. So it enables us to produce it pretty quickly at scale.
And will that be something that you'll continue to do? Is there more opportunities with some other of these metals that you talked about? Or are you looking for reaching out to someone to do it? Or are you waiting for them to come to you? Or is there a combination of both?
Yeah, so the easiest way is, a lot of the defense contractors or primes and or the government are reaching out to us asking if we can do this. And then we develop the flow sheets for us. So thankfully, we're getting covered up by opportunities. We're not out there reaching out for new ones. They're coming to us. But we're doing it for antimony now, for germanium, gallium, terbium, and ultimately want to make sure we supply these crucial industries. The facility I'm in right now was never intended to go commercial, but we're going commercial with over 200 metric tons of rare earth oxides, which are anywhere from a 99.9 to 5.9's purity. And that can satisfy most of the defense industry for these unique metals that are needed. And that's our goal. That's the primary focus of our business today, along with our large magnet customers that we already have on the rare earth oxide side of the business.
Yeah. And lastly, Mark, can it all be done in like one facility that you're in right now? Is the goal to eventually have other facilities around the United States? Is that something that you've looked at already?
Yeah, our business is about scale and rapid growth, but the defense industry can be satisfied out of this small facility we're in today. We have our 400,000 square foot facility in Marion, Indiana, 45 minutes north of here. We are working with economic development groups in states like South Carolina, Texas, and others that potentially build another facility. We have our Kentucky site. We have our South African site, which we have a $100 million commitment from Novare for. And then deploying our technology with other partners about collaboration, about driving down cost structure. We want to compete on producing these materials, but we want to compete based on cost, because that's how we survive for the next 20, 30, 40 years and bring this industry back home, bring it back home to America, bring it back home to our allied nations to completely displace the monopoly that exists today.
Makes a lot of sense. Mark, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you, and we'll talk soon.
Steve, thank you so much. Appreciate your guys' time.
All right, there's Mark Jensen, the CEO of American Resources Corp.